Hi, I'm Nami and welcome to Mike and Nami Plus. Today I'm going to talk about why I need to have a third C-section. It is mandatory for me and I'm just basically going to talk about like my birthing history, also why this one has to be mandatory. When I was giving birth to our first son, Galahad, Michael and I did a very detailed video about his birthing story and you can see that linked right here on my channel. It was very complicated and I basically had my water break. Only 20% of women have their water break before they actually go into labor. 80% of the time, the doctor has to forcibly break the membrane in the uterus of the amniotic sac to allow the water to flow out so the baby can also flow out. Normally, like in the movies, you see like, oh my gosh, my water's broken and I need to go to the hospital. Like that doesn't happen in real life. It only happens 20% of the time, but it happened to me where my water was broken. And because I was 1 week overdue my due date, we needed to get the baby out as soon as possible because it's not safe for the baby to stay in the womb for too long when they are overdue because they tend to poo in the uterus. Babies are only supposed to have their first poo after they're born. The type of poo that it is very sticky and almost black, blackish green. It's called meconium. And that poo has been accumulated in their intestines from the nutrients that was provided through the blood of the umbilical cord connected to the uterus and connected to me feeding the baby. Because Galahad already had meconium in his amniotic fluid, the water that's in the womb, we actually had to induce me. But my induction failed because to give birth, your cervix, which is the area right underneath the amniotic sac where the baby is housed, the little section where the baby needs to pass through the canal, the whole of the cervix has to dilate. It has to open up to 10 centimeters. However, for me, I was only 3 centimeters after 23 hours of having this hormone in me. But some ladies, they give birth in like 2 hours. Like they fully dilate in 2 hours. But for me, I was only 3 centimeters. So my midwife at that time, she said, if you know you were like 7 or 8 centimeters, we would try to push and we would try to get the baby out. But because you're only 3 centimeters, it's been 23 hours. You are having a fever now because your water is already broken. When the amniotic sac breaks, then your uterus can't protect against infections. I had an urinary infection. And that caused me to have a fever. It caused Galahad's heart rate to rise as well because my body was hot. And so the midwife said we need to get the baby out as soon as possible. Therefore, we're going to have an emergency C-section. I think I did a video about why I had to have the second C-section, which I will also link right up here. We also had to consider if I was able to have a VBAC or not. You have to have like perfect conditions within 1 week of your due date. You have to go into labor yourself. I basically didn't qualify for all of those. Ziek was also a week late. There was no sign of contractions, same as Galahad's. So because I have no contractions, we're already a week late. We're gonna have to do our elective C-section. It's like a C-section by choice, but it's not really a choice for me because like I had to have an emergency C-section the first time and I don't qualify for having a natural birth the second time. And so I had to choose an elective C-section. Another qualification you need to be eligible to have a VBAC is actually only having one previous C-section. So let's say you have 5 kids, but you only had one C-section. Let's say the third child was a C-section, then you can still try for VBACs. However, let's say you have 5 kids and you had 2 C-sections before, that means every other birth after that second C-section must be an elective C-section because once you have 2 C-sections and once you cut your abdomen and you cut your uterus twice, the risk of having a uterine rupture, which you can imagine what that is, it's basically your uterus ruptures, that chance becomes very, very high. They normally don't allow you to try for a VBAC or to have a natural birth after having 2 C-sections already. So because I have had 2 C-sections already, I am not allowed to try having a natural birth. I have to have a mandatory elective C-section. We have to book our C-section around a week before the due date, just in case you do go into labor yourself, the contractions won't conflict with the C-section surgery. I'm not too worried because I've been through the surgery twice already. The second time, the recovery was a lot easier because I didn't have to go through all of that crazy like complications beforehand. Literally, it was just me walk in to the hospital, get the surgery done. Surgery is 2 hours long, recover in the hospital for 2 days, and then go home. But with Galahad's, because I lost so much blood, I lost, I think, 2 liters of blood. My hemoglobin levels were almost half of normal average rates for hemoglobin for women my age. Yeah, I was like a zombie. I basically like died and come back with Galahad's birth. If it wasn't for the surgery and if it wasn't for medical technology advancements of this era, I probably would have not have made it. And because Galahad was in an incubator afterwards for 6 days because he couldn't breathe properly, he had to have an oxygen mask. He also had like a lot of clogging in his bloodstream with bilirubin, which is a protein that causes jaundice, which is a condition that comes from too much bilirubin protein in your bloodstream. It blocks the bloodstream and it doesn't let the blood flow. So he had to have treatment, like light therapy for that too. Both Galahad and I wouldn't have made it. And if that's the case, then Ziek wouldn't be here today as well. So I'm actually really thankful, like, even though I have to have surgery 3 times, I've never had any other type of surgeries before. And yeah, I think it's good. Like, I'm looking forward to this time. But yeah, this is probably going to be our last baby, which is why we were wondering when we should have our third child, because of my birthing complications. And that's why this pregnancy was such a surprise to us, because we were actually considering holding off until we're really sure that we want to have our third child at the timing that we would have thought would be best. But I feel like this timing is like everything is just like falling nicely into place. And even though it was a complete surprise, I feel like it's been such a blessing and we've been so excited, and like our whole family has been so excited. And like, even Ziek is like showing interest. He thinks that he has a baby in his own tummy, because I'm saying things like, oh, be careful, like mommy's tummy is hurting, the baby inside is gonna hurt, the baby's inside a water balloon, and if you squish too hard or if you climb on my belly, then the water balloon's gonna pop and the baby's gonna get hurt. So he like thinks, oh, baby inside, and then he says like, oh, baby inside, like for himself too. So it's kind of cute. I feel like it's kind of like a bonding opportunity for our family. And I don't know, I feel like we're just really excited. But yeah, I'm gonna do a separate video talking about why we can't physically have more children, and also like why we're kind of choosing to go this route. If you'd like to see that video, we're probably gonna upload it after this one. You can click here. I'll put a card once it's up. I feel like so blessed. And I think I was scared to have another son too. So that's why like we're wondering if we should wait. Cause I don't know if we could have been able to handle 3 boys. This pregnancy has really just been blessing on top of blessing on top of blessing. If you learned something in this video, give this video a thumbs up so I can see if it helped you in any way. And make sure you turn on your bell notification right beside the subscribe button so that you can know right when the other video comes out. And we'll see you next time. Bye.